What's up YouTube, it's Zapdos Tish here, and this is the first episode in 2012. I hope you all had a nice year, and that this year will be even better, and they say that 2012 is the end of the world, and if they were taught about the Pokemon trading card game, they were right, because it's the end of the game as you knew it in 2011, and you probably know already why. Well, 2012 is the year where the EX cards join our format once again. So what's an EX card? Well, EX cards are basically the same as Prime and Level X cards, meaning they're more expensive and rare than other cards in the set, but EX cards really stand out because they're so powerful and have a ton of HP. Remember Wailer DX of EX Sandstorm? Yeah, what a beast that was, with an HP of 200 at that time, which was never heard of for a stage 1, was really insane. Well, in our next set called Next Destinies, we'll be getting back those powerful EX cards. Just look at Kyurem EX, an HP of 180 for a basic Pokemon. That's just making fun of our basic Pokemon like Tinamo, Silosis, or Oddish that only have 30 or 40 HP. So is there any downsides to this incredible power? Well, yes, there is. The downside is that you can take two prize cards if you knock out an EX card instead of just one, which makes me think about using Rayquaza and Deoxys Legend to knock out a single Pokemon and get 3 prize cards with 1 knockout. Wow, you already won half of the game that way, so the matches will go a lot faster, and if you can't keep up with the power and speed, you won't even make it. So energy acceleration will definitely be used a lot by using tech cards or newer item cards to tank up these powerful cards. Now enough about the EX cards, since they're only coming out February 8th, so we have to wait a couple of weeks for that. Now to the main deck analysis of this episode, 6 corners. Well, since I already made a battle video showing you the deck, you probably think that it isn't that good, but don't underestimate it just yet. I know this deck is really weak against trainer lock decks, but the fact still remains that it can easily counter every weakness in our current format. So what's in this deck? Well, to start off, this deck only runs on high HP basics like Zekrom, Reshiram, Kyurem, Terrakion, Cobalion, and of course Virizion, which is the main starter of your deck. So you start off with a Virizion as your active, and then you'll be able to draw cards with its first attack and knock out some weak basics with your second attack to get some fast prize cards. And then while Virizion is set up, you can use Collector or something to get out the Pokemon you'll need in a certain matchup. So for example, if you're up against Magnezone, get out Terrakion. If you're up against Reshiflosion, get out Kyurem and stuff like that. So what we're gonna do if you're up against Chandelure? Well, there's also a card out there that can easily counter that one, Absol Prime. I've seen a couple of 6 corner decks running a single Absol Prime just for that reason, because this deck runs a maximum of 4 rainbow energies, so you can afford every type in your deck. Also, Shaman is a solid choice in your deck because you can save your energies that way and move them to another attacker. It also runs on double cardless energies for your dragons to use Outrage, and then a couple of grass energies and 1 or 2 fighting energies for your opening move Viridian, and to build up Terrakion, because lightning decks are still incredibly popular thanks to Electric. And now that we know the energies and which Pokemon are in this deck, we need to look at the possible trainers and supporters. Well, to start off, Switch is definitely needed in this deck because of the heavy retreaters. Also, Super Scoop Up could do the trick, but that's a bit risky. Aside to that, Catcher is the main item card in this deck because you're going after the weakness of a Pokemon, and then Eviolite, which is simply perfect in this deck because all your Pokemon are basic and then they'll be much harder to knock out, and they were hard to knock out in the first place, so that's good. And also, 1 Super Rod could also be come in handy if you're planning on reusing certain Pokemon or basic energies. And of course, Junk Comp to get back all this good stuff. As for the supporters, just make sure you run 4 collectors, 7 to 9 draw supporters like Professor Oak's new tier 8, Juniper, maybe Copycat or even Chirin, just for the consistency. I already tested this deck out, but it hasn't proven itself in my eyes just because it was up against a trainer lock deck, and yeah, it isn't that good against trainer lock decks. But if it's up against a normal deck without trainer lock, it's very efficient, so try it out and let me know how good it actually is. And I believe that's it for my first deck analysis of 2012. Now to Poke News. Well, there isn't that much news this week, and yeah, that's probably because of the holiday season or something. Anyways, there's news about the 5th Japanese black and white set, which will be released on March 16th, and as we know, we'll get a new element this time. The dragon type will be included, so we'll have new energies, as well as there's rumors of a special dragon type energy, which will be included in the set, and it'll remind everyone of the old school special darkness and the special metal energy, meaning if that energy is attached to a dragon, it'll have a certain effect. What that effect is still a mystery to everyone, and there's good news for the people that still don't have the rare candies they want, because that Japanese set will also come out with 2 30 card decks that I already mentioned in a previous episode, and they'll both come with at least 1 rare candy inside, as well as the special energy I talked about. So that's good news indeed for the people who still want to get in the game and still don't have the cards like rare candy. And the last news of this Japanese set is actually Ninetales. What? Ninetales? Yeah, that's right. Ninetales will be the box topper of that set. They didn't include a dragon type because they didn't want to spoil the dragon type just yet. And to finish off Poke News, I'd like to talk about the video games instead of the usual trading card game for a while, because otherwise Poke News wouldn't be that amazing. Anyways, I'm sure you all like the games just like me. I played them a lot back in the days, and you have all played Black or White before, I'm sure of it. Well, this year, meaning 2012, there will probably be a new game, and it'll be a 3rd addition to the Unova region. It's rumored to be called Pokemon Gray, because if you put together black and white, what do you get? Exactly. Exactly, Pokemon Great. And that's not all, more rumors have spread over the internet saying there will be a remake of Ruby and Sapphire for the 3DS, just like they made one for Gold and Silver for the regular DS. So really epic news indeed, and I'll probably get into the video games as well, since I used to play them a lot back in the days. Maybe I can even start making walkthroughs one day. But for now, let's stick with the good old trading card game, or rather yet, the new card game, which will be full of EX cards. Just look out for them, I just can't wait. I hope you people are excited as me just for this new EX cards to be released. Anyways, that's all for now. I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, click the thumbs up, I really appreciate that. And as always, if you have any questions, thoughts, or epic new ideas for 2012, post them in the comment section below. And for all the people that haven't subscribed yet, what the hell is your problem? Anyways, you'll get the chance at the end of the video, that way you'll stay tuned for the latest updates. Anyways, this was SabdosTCG, happy new year, and until next time!